This is what the people who want this to happen, whoever they are, be it the president, or Wyatt, I don't know. The people who do and don't want this to happen. The architect of this, and I would put my friend this man, in the circle of people that have designed this. One of the arguments or questions that people have, why are there three phases? Why don't we just repeal it and replace it in one fell swoop? Just send a repeal bill up like they did six times. And I've asked that question. And the answer I've gotten is that it's not the responsible way to do it, because there's an opportunity here to do a lot of really good things. But we can't do it all at once. And we're going to have trouble doing it anyway because of the makeup in the Senate, where there are only 52 Republican votes. So just in a brief outline fashion, as it's been explained to me, the objective here is first to have this bill that's being voted on maybe today in the House passed and get sent to the Senate, understanding that this is not the bill that's going to be sent to the president to sign, understanding that this is not the final form, this is just getting the ball rolling, that the people behind this are not naive enough to think that the first bill they write and submit is going to be signed off on by everybody, survive a conference committee meeting, and sent to the president. It's going to undergo massive changes. And it may not pass out of the Senate anyway, but the objective is to actually fix the problem, with the realization that the fix cannot occur overnight because our health care circumstance right now is the result of at least 50 years of incremental government meddling. Not to say it's going to take 50 years to stop it, or to replace it or overturn it, but it's not something that can be done overnight. And the key is to leave enough of Obamacare intact to empower our Health and Human Secretary, Tom Price, to extract a bunch of things as permitted by the law that the Obama people put in that didn't get put in as part of the original legislation. One of the things about the original Obamacare bill was it left the discretion on much of the health benefits and the taxes and any number of things up to the secretary. In this case, the Secretary of Health and Human Services. The people behind this bill want to be able, with those provisions, to strip it bare, to take those things out. What kind of things am I talking about? Well, just in an article, I think from, I'm not sure it's USA Today, the GOP bill eliminates the Obama statute fine on those who do not obtain coverage. It eliminates the generous subsidy. It doesn't eliminate subsidies. It eliminates these out-of-control, not based in reality, subsidies that were used to buy support or buy votes. Republican tax credits would be based on age, not income. The bill would end Obama's Medicaid expansion. It would trim future federal financing for the federal-state program and let states impose work requirements on some of its 70 million beneficiaries. House leaders recently proposed a fresh amendment to be voted on today, repealing Obama's requirement that insurers cover 10 specified services. These are among the things they want Tom Price to pull out. These 10 specified services that Obama made insurance companies cover for everybody, which raised premiums, maternity, and mental health. What if you're a guy and you don't need maternity leave? You have to buy it anyway for Obama. It gets factored into what the insurance company charges you. because Obama put in that it's mandatory. And he didn't put in mandatory only for his women, just for everybody. It ran everybody's premium. Same thing with mental health care. What if you don't need it? Doesn't matter. You're